It's fun to watch a student come into the classroom with really basic to little understanding on the topic you're teaching, and then send them out of the classroom at the end of the semester prepared in the skill set and kind of looking forward to kind of build that next skill set or that next course. My name is Brian Hampton. I'm in the Department of Geological Sciences at New Mexico State University, and I'm a sedimentologist and stratigrapher that uses the sedimentary rocks and stratigraphic record to understand tectonic events. Sedimentology is really the study of the process by which sediment is deposited. When we talk about stratigraphy, what we're really trying to do is compare and contrast how these rocks organize when we go from one locality to another locality, or how they might change or evolve as we take a look up section through geologic time. So I'm originally from the Pacific Northwest, and I spent a lot of time growing up doing a lot of outdoor activities. And when I ended up going off to college, I really was undecided for my major. And I stumbled across a 100-level Introduction to Geology course. It was volcanoes, earthquakes, dinosaurs, all the things that catch your eye. A little later in my degree, we ended up taking a long field trip down to the southwestern US, and that was my first time ever getting down into that part of the world. That was an eye-opening experience for me to get down in these areas, get down in parts of Arizona, New Mexico, southern Utah, southern Colorado, and the geology here is world-class. It's stunning. At that point, that pretty much sealed the deal in terms of knowing I wanted to continue on in the geological sciences. So I teach a wide range of courses in the Department of Geological Sciences, everything from the intro level for both non-majors and majors, right up through graduate courses where we're really trying to get our graduate students focused in on sedimentary and tectonic themes. The unifying theme for my teaching in all of those courses is that we're always trying to get students to pick up the geologic language, but we can find that that can be quite intimidating as they're working their way through the major. So one of the things is really kind of instilling a sense of confidence, a sense of ownership in how they go about studying rocks and basically parlaying that into how the Earth is working. So for a number of the field trips we take for our courses, a lot of times in many departments, there's a show and tell aspect of field trips, and we certainly bring that in, but we also want students kind of getting out and putting them up front where we're kind of in the background and having them generally describe what they're seeing first. They've seen a number of these fossils in class. We've diagrammed and sketched them. And it's always kind of fun when they can take a 15-minute drive right up the road and start taking a look at these things in the context of rock that hasn't been collected and put in a classroom. I think it's one of the selling points for this major is that we do have a lot of hands-on activity. As soon as they realize that they can go on these field trips, get out in the field, get a little exercise, and understand how the Earth works, people get pretty excited about it. The strategy I find is, first off, getting these students excited about geology. And it doesn't matter whether you're a major or you're a non-major, it's not hard to get excited about the geological sciences, especially in a locality like southern New Mexico. The best aspect to teaching is basically the students. It's always been the students. I really like teaching because it keeps me fresh in my research, it keeps me fresh in my skill set. It's also a great way to kind of keep up to date on some of the new data, some of the new things that are coming out in the field of geological sciences. And I think some of the best teachers are the ones that like the learning process. Once you start learning, it's one of these things you can't ever really turn it off. So it really becomes part of your day-to-day life. It doesn't end when you walk out of the classroom. It doesn't end when you put on your research hat and take your teaching hat off. It doesn't end on vacation. And I think that's probably one of the best parts about teaching for me. Boy, the most challenging aspect of teaching is probably figuring out who your audience is within the first day or at least the first week of the semester. And I think once you have that established, you've got probably a recipe for success in terms of moving the class forward. So it's one of these areas where I can get up in the morning, I can go trail running, I can walk into the classroom, we can take a field trip. All parts of your daily life is kind of fitting into the geology. So the rocks, the people, yeah, that's what keeps me at New Mexico State University in Las Cruces. Brian Hampton, Department of Geological Sciences, College of Arts and Sciences.